Hello guys, my name is Destiny and welcome back to my channel. So in the last video, we went ahead and configured our login and logout system here in Django Stack Overflow clone. And in today's video, we're gonna go ahead and start working with the user profile picture and a whole lot of things that's gonna work with the profile, that's gonna deal with uploading picture, resizing picture, and a whole lot of interesting things. So before we go ahead and get started, do make sure to drop a like, comment, and consider subscribing if you are enjoying what I'm doing here, as it will really mean the world to me and help my channel. So let's get started. Okay, the first thing we want to do is very simple. So we just want to come over to our models.py and we want to create a model that's going to help us collect the informations of a user, so, and upload it to their profile. So how do we do that? Now we want to import user from, so we're going to say from django.contrib.auth.models. we want to import user. So after this, now we're going to define a class and we're going to call this one profile. So it's going to inherit from models.model, just like that. And we need a couple things here for this class profile. Firstly, we need the user. So the user is going to be set to models.1:1 field. So I'm going to explain what this is doing, and we're going to pass in the user. Then the next thing we want to pass in is on delete should be set to equal to models.cascade, just like that. Okay, let me explain what we did over here. Okay, the first thing is set users is equal to models.1:1 field. Now what is 1:1 field? You know, one user is supposed to have one profile. One user cannot have like two profiles. They must have a profile. So that's what 1:1 field does. It connects one user to one profile. Simple as that. It's not like many field or foreign key. We're still going to talk about that in this video, but for now, 1:1 field is what we want to use for this. So the next information that we want to collect is the image. So we want to be able to upload image. So we're going to say image should be equal to models.image field, just like that. And we're going to pass in a couple arguments in here. First one is the default name that we want to give to this. So the default name, I think this should be equal to, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, it should be equal to. So we want to call it, well, let's say we want to call it default.jpg. So that's going to be the default picture for any user that hasn't uploaded any picture. And we want to upload all these pictures to profile_picture. Okay, I think I missed something. So it's supposed to be upload_2=2 profile_pic, just like that. So profile_pic, and that should be good. Okay, the next thing we want to do is very simple. We're going to collect one last information. And okay, I think let's just stick with this one for now. Now I'm just gonna pass an image. So I'm just gonna define a dunder str. So I'm gonna say dunder str, and we're gonna say this to this that's already set. It's to, it's gonna take self, and there's gonna be a colon over there. So what we want to return is very easy. We're just going to return an f formatted string, and this f formatted string is simply going to just call self dot user dot username, then it's gonna say profile. So what is it's gonna do is it's simply gonna get the self dot the logged in user, and it's gonna get their username and say profile. So in other words, what it's gonna say is something like destiny dash profile. Hopefully you understand. So you're just gonna call my name or whoever's name, then call profile close to it. So that's pretty much what we want to do. Let's just go ahead and register this in the admin panel. So in the admin section, we're gonna say from dots models we import it's called profile. The next thing we're gonna say is admin.sites.register, and we're gonna pass in profile, just like that. So with this, now we registered it, we can just close this and let's open up our terminal. So let's reopen up our terminal, and you guys remember we downloaded something from way back when we started this video. It's called Pillow. So I told you guys that whenever we're going to work with images, that Pillow is really going to help us do that. So that's why we installed Pillow then. So we're going to start using it now. So the first thing I want to do is make migrations. And you might ask me something like, hey, what does migrations do? What does make migrations do? So whenever we create something in our model and we want to want to like push it to our website, to our database, I mean, we're going to make migration. So it's going to just make migrations to our database. Then after that, we're going to migrate it finally. So we're going to say migrate and it's going to migrate it to our database. So right now, if we open up our website, come over to this slash admin, and let's see. Okay, it's not running yet. Let's make our server to start running again. And it's running now. Let's refresh this and let's log in as Destiny. Now you can see we have profiles over here, and if we open this up, you see that we have this pretty nice place that we can add profile images from. So that's not bad. That's actually pretty good. So with that, now the next thing I want to do is something that's very important. Okay, I want to also include a bio. So let's say I want the user to be also able to add a bio to their profile. So this bio is going to have a chat field. Mass underscore length is going to be 1000. Very easy. And let's say I also need a phone. So I need a phone number. This is going to be set to models.integer field, just like this. And there should be nothing in it. Yeah. Okay, I think that's pretty much what we want to do. Again, we are just going to make migrations and finally migrate again. So whenever you do something, you want to make sure you migrate. So I'm going to do this one. Yeah, okay. So it's automatically did that for us. Okay, so I'm now going to make migrate. So let's migrate. Okay, so we migrated. Now let's run our server again. So we're going to say run server, just like that. Okay, now it's running our server. Let's come over here and refresh. Working good. Okay, the next thing we're gonna do is come back to our database, and we want to add a profile now. So let's say we want to add a profile for Destiny, and his bio should be like software engineer. His phone, let's just choose, these are just dummy numbers, let's just choose anyone. Let's say this. And also for this, let's just choose anything at all goes. I'm just looking for what to pick. Okay, let's say I want to go with this. Okay, I'm just gonna open that and click save. So now I save, it's actually worked fine. We have this image, but right now you see that this image is going to nowhere. So let me show you guys something. Now if we open up our Visual Studio Code, you now see that we have a folder named profile underscore pic. So this is where our profile pictures will be uploaded to, but I don't actually want it to upload there. I want it to upload to like a specific folder where we are going to also have the default picture in case a user has not uploaded a profile picture for themselves. Hopefully you understand what I'm saying. And I don't know, I really talk fast when I'm so anxious and I'm happy teaching. So let's get back to, I'll try my possible best to talk as slow as possible. So yeah, calm down, Destiny. Okay, let's go ahead. So in our settings.py, just over here, we want to add two things. The first one is going to be media URL. So I want media URL to be set to media. And also there is, okay, let's make sure that we are putting an equal to over there. And also I want somewhere also that's called media root. So I want media root to be set to os.path.join. Then I want to join the base directory with media, just like that. So right now when we come over to our website again, come over here and we refresh this, it's not running. Let's see, let's make this run again. Okay, it's running now. Now let's actually get back to the admin page. So this is the admin page. We come over to profile. Now we want to add a new profile. Let's actually delete this one. So we're gonna delete this one. Go delete it. Yeah, so I want to add it again. Now I'm gonna add it to Destiny, as a Destiny, as a software engineer, phone, let's just say 080111, whatever. And I'm gonna choose a file for it. So I'm just choosing anything, and I'm gonna click save. So after this, now you'll see that when we get back to our Visual Studio Code, now we have a new folder named media, and in here we have a new folder named profile pic, and we upload our picture to it. So that's like a more better way of doing this. than the other way we did it. So we can go ahead and delete this other profile underscore pick directory, and everything should still work totally fine the way it was working. So now I want to show you guys something remotely. So we're gonna work with our shell a bit. Let me just clear this out. Okay, so we want to work a bit with ORM, and ORM in Django means Objects Relational Mapper. It simply helps us do some specific dynamic things with our shell here in Python. So first thing I want to say is Python manage.py, and we're gonna call shell just like that. So in this shell, there's a whole lot of things that we can do. I want to import user, so I'm gonna say from django.contrib.auth.models, I want to import user just like that. And now when we call user, what do you see? We don't actually see anything, and that's because we need to do something. So I want to set user to user.objects. I think it's objects, yeah, objects.filter. So I want to filter a user by username is equal to destiny. So we have a username, a user that's destiny. So I want to filter him with a dot first method. So right now when we call user, you see get destiny. Hopefully you understand what I did over here. It's pretty easy. So what I did was user.objects.filter. I got a user that has the username of destiny, and I got it as the first over there. So now when I call user, it calls destiny, and that's because I assigned it to this variable over here. So there's a whole lot of things I can do with this now. For example, I can access user's image by saying user.go to their profile.access the image. Now you can see this is the image, the image URL, like the image link, that's where the image is. And I can also access the image with, you can do a whole lot of things. I can say user.profile.image. Let's say width. So you can say I said width. I can also access the height. See, you can do a whole lot of things, and the most important one, I can access the URL. So that's the URL where the image is stored, and we'll be using this one a minute from now. So I actually want to show you guys that you can do a whole lot of things from the ORM. You can access the user image height, the width, the profile image, and a whole lot of things. And also, do you know that you can access the bio? So you can say, okay, let's see if you can access the bio. So we can say user.profile.bio. So what do you see? You see software engineer, and you can also access the phone, and you get the phone over here. So the way we call this user.profile.phone, that's the same way we're gonna call it in our code editor, and it's gonna show up on our website. So hopefully I'm not really talking too fast. Let's go ahead and show you guys what I actually meant over here. So what you want to do is very easy. Right now I'm just gonna close up this. Let's just exit from the terminal. I'm gonna clear this, and I'm gonna run my server again. Okay, I run my server again. Everything is working fine now. So you want to make sure that you have this in your settings.py to make sure that everything is going to work when you're working with pictures. So right now I told you guys that we have this media over here looking good, not bad. So I want to minimize this. Okay, after all this, the next thing I'm gonna do is very easy. I'm just gonna go ahead and display the profile picture in our profile page. But right now we don't have a profile yet, so let's create a profile. So in our views.py, we want to create a new function, and this function is gonna have define profile, and we're gonna pass in a request to it. So pass in a request, and we want to return just render, just like this. We're gonna return render, but this time around it's gonna be profile.html, and we don't need any form in here. We're good. So we don't need any form, and we also need this login required thing over there. Okay, so that's what we need. Now we also need a URL, so let's configure a URL for it. Let's add a comment, and we're gonna call this profile system. Yeah, let's just say profile system. So I'm just doing this so that you could be able to read this code without any stress. So parts, now when we go over to profile, and we come over to I should import it. So from user views, yeah, dots profile, yeah, just like that. I'm also gonna give it a name. We're gonna call it profile, and don't forget your comma. Okay, so after this, now We already have a view, we have a URL, now we need a template. So how do we get a template? Quite easy. I told you guys that we already have almost all the templates built out. So we're just gonna copy profile, the HTML, we're gonna come over here, we're gonna paste them in here. So right now I think we have profile.html. Now let's see if it's gonna work. So we come over to this slash profile. Okay, not bad, pretty working good. But it says invalid block tag. This, do you forget to load the stack? Let's go ahead and actually clean things up. So first thing I'm gonna do is copy this over here, come over to my urls.py. I'm gonna paste it down here. Let's see what we have. Okay, so let's refresh this again and boom, as you can see, we have our profile page. Not bad, but this time around we want to go ahead and display the profile image here. We're going to display the bio somewhere here, we're going to display the email, the phone and other things. So let's go ahead and do it. So firstly, we're going to start with the username. So we're going to display the username over here. I already specified it. So we're going to say doom that, double curly brackets, and we're going to say user dot username, just like that. So now when we refresh, you see we get destiny. But I actually want to capitalize the first letter of every user automatically. I don't want them to do it themselves. So I'm just going to put a pipe and I'm going to add title over there. So when I refresh now, you see we get destiny. Okay, that's pretty good. Now the next thing should be the bio. So the bio, so I'm just going to copy this over here and just down here I'm going to paste this. And if you want to access the bio, it's going to be user.profile.bio. And now when we refresh, you see we get software engineer. Pretty good. Now I want to access the image. So how do we do that? Let's look for where the images start. Okay, this is it over here. So we're going to paste the same thing and we're going to say user.profile.image.url, just like that. And now when we refresh, let's see. Okay, not working yet. We are still gonna fix it. Don't freak out. Okay, so user.profile.image.url, but not still working. I'm gonna show you guys why it's not working. So now let's add email and phone. So for the email, come over here, paste this. So we're gonna say user.email. As you can see, it gets destiny. That's just what I added as the email. Let me get rid of this. Okay, as you can see, it adds desfix@gmail.com. Then for this, it's gonna be user.profile.bio. Now let's refresh this. As you can see, it's got the bio over here, but actually we want it to be phone. So when we refresh this now, you see it's the phone that it gets. Okay, everything is working pretty good now, apart from the fact that the picture isn't showing up yet. So how do you make the picture show up? Let's go and do it. Okay, now when we get back to our code, we want to get to urls.py. Let's get over to urls.py. This is it over here. So I want to append something just down here. It's kind of tricky. You usually forget it if you're a beginner. So I'm going to say if settings.debug is true, then I want to append something to the URL patterns. I'm going to say URL pattern should be plus equals. So I'm appending something to it. And I want to append static. But actually, before I append this, I want to import a couple of things from here. So I'm going to say from django.conf import settings. So from django.conf import settings. And also from django.conf. I think it should be the URLs. Let's see. Yeah, dot URLs dot static import static. Yeah. So I'm gonna say URL pattern static, just like that. I'm gonna open up a parenthesis and I'm gonna call settings. Oh, sorry, it's supposed to be in lowercase. So everything's supposed to be lowercase. So I'm gonna call settings.media_URL. You remember the media URL that we gave in our settings.py? Let's locate it. Let's see. Okay, it's wasting my time. So let's just go ahead. I'm still gonna show you guys later. Then after this, I want to connect the document root. So I'm gonna say document_root. I want to connect this to settings.media_root. It's easy as that. So document route should be media route, which we have over here. Now for the other one, I want to show you guys. Let me look for it. Okay, this is it over here. So you see we have settings should be equal to media URL. So we want to locate the media URL. We want to actually get it. And this is where we passed it in, media URL. It's in the folder named media. Okay, it's in slash media. This is the URL, it's in slash media. So with what we did now, if you come over here and refresh, okay, our site is not running. Let's get back to our terminal and see. Let's see, settings has no attribute, the code. Let's break off from this and let's run it again. If it gets the same error, we go ahead and fix it. Okay, it didn't actually get the same error. Okay, what do you notice right now? We get our picture. So this is looking pretty good. Now we have a picture, we have a username, we have a bio, we have email, we have phone number, and a whole lot of things. So I think that's pretty much what we want to do here. We have actually achieved some really nice things here. The next thing I would want to show you guys is how to automatically create profile for a new user. So let me show you guys something. If we log out and get back to sign up, so let's say we want to sign up a new user and sign up. Okay, what's going on over here? Let's see. Okay, I know what's going on. So in the register, let's get over to views.py. I want to get this out of the register page. Okay, so come over to sign up. Now let's say I want to sign up a user to be, and I'm going to set an email for him. I'm going to set a password, testing 321. Click sign up. It creates an account for him. Then I try logging in as him, the Toby guy. And when we log in now, what do you notice? Nothing. So if you come over to his profile now, let's come over to slash profile. You know, we are logging as Toby now. Now we come over to his profile. What do you notice? His email shows up. He has no number. He has no profile picture. So he has to come over to our admin and do it himself. And that's a bad idea. Number one, we want to automatically upload a profile, a default profile picture for him. Number two, we're going to allow him update his profile himself. So let's go ahead and automatically update a new profile picture for him. That should be pretty easy. Let's just do it. Okay, in here in the stack users, I'm going to create a new file. I'm going to call this signals.py, just like that. So signals.py, in here we're gonna have a couple things. For example, I'm gonna say from django.db.models.signals. I wanna import post save. Okay, I imported post save, then from django.contrib.auth.models, I wanna import user, just like that, and from django.dispatch. So I want to import receiver, just like that. Let's see if the spelling is right. So I want to import receiver. Then finally from .models, I want to import profile. Okay, so that's what I want to do. Now the next thing I'm going to do is just define, let's just come down here, and we're going to define create_profile. So this is going to help us create profile. And in here, we want to pass in a couple of things. We're going to pass in sender, we're going to pass in instance, we're going to pass in created, and finally we're going to pass in keyword arguments. Yeah, just keyword arguments, that's what I want to pass in. Okay, so keyword arguments, and we close off that. So with this, now I want to check if a profile is already created. So if a profile is created, what do I want to do? If an account is created, what do I want to do? I want to create a profile. So I'm just going to say profile.object.create. Simple as that. Then I'm going to pass in user should be equals to instance. So what this does is quite self-explanatory. It's going to get the logged in user, and it's going to create a profile with his information automatically. Hopefully you understand. If you don't understand, that means you are new to Django. Don't worry, with time you're going to understand. So after this, now the next thing I want to do is very simple. I want to also define save underscore profile. So this is going to help us save a profile, and in here I'm going to pass in I think I'm going to pass in post save sender instance and keyword args. I'm going to pass in keyword args, just like that. Okay, so what I want to do here is quite simple. I'm just going to say instance.profile.save. As easy as that. I'm saving the profile now. So now I want to call at a receiver method. So I'm going to say receiver. I'm going to pass in post save there at the top. And also I'm going to say sender should be equal to the user. And also I want to put the same thing. Let's make sure we are actually getting it right. I want to put the same thing here. Okay, make sure everything is looking good. Okay, after this, now the next thing I want to do is just go ahead and configure it in my app.py. So open up app.py and we're going to create a ready function over here. So we create a ready function, not bad, passing self as the parameter, and we're going to import. So we want to import stack users dot signals. Okay, so stack users dot signals, and this should be it. But most of the times, I don't know why, whenever I do this, I usually get an error. I just hope I don't get an error now, but whatever. If we get an error, we're gonna fix it ASAP. Okay, I want to get rid of some of the users over here. I'm just gonna leave one. Okay, let's say I want to leave a Karen. Okay, I'm gonna leave Karen D. I'm gonna delete the users just like that, like that. Okay, so I want to sign up a new user. I'm gonna log out. I'm gonna come up to sign up, and I want to sign up a user called Tom. His email is gonna be tom@gmail.com. He's gonna have a password testing 321, and let's confirm his password testing 321. Hit sign up. Okay, so now it says not null constraints field. Stack users underscore profile phone. So it's self-explanatory. All we have to do is come over here, pass in null equal to true. Also let's pass in blank equal to true. It's easy as that. Now we need to migrate. You remember I told you guys, whenever you do anything in your models, you migrate and make migrations. Yeah, it's a simple rule. It's like a convention, something like that. So we did that already. Now let's run our server again. We run our server and we refresh the site. Okay, let's just come over to here and see if it's created a user for us. Okay, it's created a user Tom. Let's come over to profile. Okay, it didn't create a profile for Tom. Don't worry, we're still gonna fix that right now. Okay, let's go ahead and do something. So I'm gonna create a new user Tom11. I'm gonna add in a password over there. Let's add in another password and hit sign up. So we get in this error that says forbidden. Okay, forbidden. Yeah, it's a normal CSRF error. Let's do it again. I think it's created the user. Let's see. Okay, it's then actually create a user. So let's do it again. So Tom111. The username, the email can be whatever. Then we'll add this 2 to the back and we hit sign up. So as you can see, it says account successfully created for Tom111. Now he can sign up. So sign in. Now when we come over to profile, what do you notice? Oh, sorry, I haven't actually configured a button yet. Okay, what do you notice? It actually gives him Tom111 of the profile, and it gives him his profile over here. Pretty good. Let's come over here and refresh this. Let's sign as Destiny. Come over to profile and boom, it creates a profile for him automatically. But right now it's not updating any picture for him automatically. And why is that? It's because we don't have any picture yet that it should upload automatically for the Tom111 guy. So let's give it a picture. Come over here, the media. I have this default picture that I want to use. So I'm just going to drop this in my Visual Studio Code. Let me make sure that I'm getting this, and I'm going to drop it in the media. It should be in the media at the top. In here. Okay, so that's where I want to put him. Now let's create a new user and see what's gonna happen. So I'm gonna come over here and I'm going to log out, come over to sign up, and I want to create a new user. Let's call this Karen22. She's going to have an email address, the password, and finally password confirmation. And let's arrange that. Okay, this account successfully created for Karen22. Now let's try logging in. Hit sign in button, and now when we try calling over to the profile page. So when we go over to the profile page, boom, it works. So as you can see now, it automatically uploads a profile picture for Karen. It uploads their email address. Their phone number is none because they were not allowed to add it when they are signing up for the account. They can only do that when they want to update their profile. So, and also we got some dummy projects over here. So at least what we wanted to achieve actually worked out fine the way we want, and it's pretty good. It's pretty amazing. So now we can upload the profile picture and we can do a whole lot of things over here. So the next thing we're going to do is, maybe let's just say we want to resize the picture, but this video is getting a little bit lengthy. I don't want it to bore you guys to death, so I'm thinking I'm going to cut it here and push it over to the next one. So in the next one, we're going to go ahead and start working with updating our profile. So when we hit the update button, we can update a new profile picture, and we can update our email, our phone number, our bio. As you can see, he doesn't have a bio now, so that we can do all that. So in the meantime, you guys just drop a like on this video. If you enjoyed it, do consider subscribing, as it means the world to me, and also drop a comment. Check out the links in the description, one might be helpful. And I hope I'll see you guys in the next video. We were gonna go ahead and start working with updating profile pictures. Trust me, it's gonna be awesome. So my love, peace out.